Now we will see the last stage, that is the fourth stage, that is the Homo sapiens. Homo sapiens are said to be more advanced. They are the more advanced form of humans to which we all human beings belong. We all belong to the Homo sapiens. Now, as it is said that these had more advanced features. What are those features? The Homo sapiens had smaller teeth, a proper shaped chin, a defined chin, round skull. The shape of the skull of the Homo sapiens was round. Whereas if you see the shape of the skull of the Neanderthals, it was less round. But the Homo sapiens, the shape of the skull was round. Now we have seen all the four stages of evolution. Let us take a quick look to the different stages of human evolution. Human evolution is divided into four stages. One, two, three, and four. Australopithecus. The second is Homo erectus. The third is Neanderthals, and the fourth is Homo sapiens. The first one walked on two legs, longer arms, and smaller brains. These are the features. Then the second one, stand erect. They could, we will just see it in short once again. Larger brains. Okay, then the third one, they were shorter and stockier, right? Then they had large faces. Their faces were long, nose, wide noses. Then skull, the skull was less round and thick. We will see the Homo sapiens now. This is for Homo sapiens. Now, Homo sapiens, what were the features? Smaller teeth, the shape of the chin was defined, a proper shape. Then shape of the skull was also round, and also increase in the brain size. Now we have seen the different stages and the different features of all the four stages of human evolution. After this, we will see the sources or evidences of human evolution. Sources or evidences of human evolution. Archaeologists, scientists, and historians are the people who have used different sources such as fossils, bones, cave paintings, tools to trace human evolution. Now, who is an archaeologist? Archaeologists are people who study the remains of the previous time. All the remains of the past are studied by archaeologists. And historians are the people who study about history. Now, there are different sources. First, we will see about fossils and bones, then about cave paintings, and then about tools and utensils. Now, first we will see fossils and bones. What are fossils and bones? Fossils and bones were the main sources. These were the main sources which helped the archaeologist and scientist to find out to which period they belong. Fossils are the remains of the earliest plants and animals which were buried inside the ground under the earth and hardened after some years. These archaeologists dig the earth, dig the ground and study with the help of these fossils and bones. And this study of fossils is known as paleontology. And the person who studies about fossils is called a paleontologist. Now, as we go to the hospital, you all might be knowing, right? There are various machines in the hospital operated, right? A person who examines our blood, when we go for doing blood tests, all the tests are done. He is called a pathologist, right? In a similar way, this person who studies about fossils is called as a paleontologist. I repeat, paleontologists are the people who study about fossils. Our next source of evidence is cave paintings. Now, do you know what a cave painting is? A cave painting is a prehistoric picture. Now, where is this picture drawn? This picture is drawn on the interior side of the cave. What is drawn on this picture? These pictures depict the pictures of human and animal figures. When we see these paintings, we come to know about the animals of that particular period. What were the animals found in that period? What animals were hunted by man? And many other things. But for painting, we need colors, right? Today, we have so many different types of colors, like we use oil colors for painting, watercolors, and many more. But in those days, there were no such colors. The colors were made of with the help of rocks and minerals. Whatever was available during that time, with that the colors were made, and with those colors the caves were painted. Now, examples of caves are Bhimbetka, which is in Madhya Pradesh in India. Then also you might be knowing the Ajanta and Ellora caves, which is in Aurangabad. It is not given in the book, but these caves are also there in Aurangabad. Then, very near to us, all of us might have seen the Elephanta caves, which is very close to Mumbai. We all might have seen the Elephanta caves. From Mumbai, we go to Elephanta caves and we can come back by evening by a ferry. After seeing about the sources of fossils and bones and cave paintings, now next we will move on to the third one, that is tools and utensils.